Good morning, children. Let us study this poem in detail. At first, let us become familiar with some of the poetic devices used in this poem, My Mother at 66. Poetic devices are the figures of speech. They are used to beautify the language. The poet has very aptly made use of a number of poetic devices in this poem. So let us now in detail study about various poetic devices used by the poet Kamala Das in the poem My Mother at 66.
My Mother at 66. This poem is written by Kamala Das. Some of the poetic devices in this poem are simile, alliteration, repetition. So, at first, let's see what is simile. Simile is that poetic device wherein we use like or as in order to compare two things. A face action like that of a corpse. What does corpse mean? Corpse means dead body. Now here, her face has turned out to be just like that of ash. And here, her face is compared to the face of a corpse. She is compared to a dead body. Her face has turned out to be like that of a dead body. Ashen face is compared with the face of a corpse using like. When we are comparing two things, when we use like or as, that is simile. When we do not use any of these like or as, and still in poem that device is used, then it is called metaphor. Now here, a face action like that of a corpse is an example of simile. It is pronounced as simile and spelled as S-I-M-I-L-E. This poetic device we compare with metaphor. In the case of a metaphor, the words like or as are not used. Whereas in simile, we use like or as. There is one more example of simile in this poem, My Mother at 66. And that example is this: ban, pay as a late winter's moon. How is late winter's moon? There is no shine. So that is what is missing. That moonlight shine is missing. And that moon, late winter's moon, the face of mother is like that of late winter's moon, where there is no shine. It has turned out to be pale, it has turned out to be wan, just like ash. So wan and pale face is compared with a late winter's moon. Remember, in the case of these two, in first one it's a like which is being used, and in the second one it's as which is used. And both these examples are of similes. Now let us see the next one. Now alliteration. My mother beside me. Now here the first sound of the words my mother me is repeated. See here, alliteration is a repetition of sound here. My mother beside me. Which sound is repeated there? M sound is repeated there. My, M. Then mother. So here you can see my mother beside me. Your M sound is repeated, and this is an example of alliteration. Alliteration is also an important poetic device. So the poet is repeating and creating kind of rhythm in that. My mother beside me. So that's a beautiful expression. And this one by repetition of the song. So why these poetic devices are used? It is to beautify the poems. Now second example is, and fair that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. See here, first sound is repeated here, fair, familiar, fear. So fair, familiar, fear. Which sound is repeated there? First sound is repeated. Fair, familiar, and fear. And we have to look for the first sound which is there in those lines. So fair, familiar, fear, word sound is the same, they are repeated again and again. And what is alliteration? Alliteration is a repetition of sound. My mother beside me. My mother next to me. But you have to look for here, in the case of alliteration, the sounds which are being repeated. In the first example, it's the ma sound which is repeated. My mother beside me. Ma, ma, ma. Whereas in this example, it's a four. Fair, familiar, and fear. And fair that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. Next example is of personification. Personification is also poetic device. The personal attributes are given to the non-living things. Now here you see the example, younger tree is sprinting. The qualities of a human being, the qualities of a person, the attributes of a person are being given to the non-living things. Trees, they are young. So trees, which are young, here it is referring to youth. And they are sprinting. Remember that trees don't sprint. But what does it show? The youth. You are full of energy. You are full of vigor. You are always ready to sprint. You are always ready to jump. You are always ready to run. So that youth, it is referring to that youth. And when she is moving in a car, she looks outside. She wants to forget that her mother has become old. And she sees the trees are moving. When you are moving in a vehicle, when you see outside through the window, what do you see? You see all the objects which are there outside. They are all on the road. And here the poet is referring to that. But the poet is using the poetic device of personification. And personification refers to the poetic device in which personal attributes are given to the non-living things. And here the non-living thing is tree, and here the poet says the trees are sprinting, and over there they are very young. So here the poet is referring to youth. Youth, which is full of vigor, full of energy, when man is full of movement, doing something or other thing, that is what is youth. Now, it is symbolic of youth and freshness of life going past. It also personifies the trees as they are running. Now, let us move on to the next. That is repetition. In order to give emphasis, here there is a repetition. Smile, smile, smile. All I did was smile and smile and smile. It's quite easy to find out. And this poetic device, repetition, is being used in order to emphasize that she wants to forget about the old age of her mother. She wants to forget that she is going to lose the fact, the very saddening fact that her mother is bound to die. she's on the verge of death, she wants to forget about all that, and that's why she wants to bear a smile. She just wants to forget about all that and keep herself happy. The repetition emphasizes a futile repetition of an action. And here, she does not reveal this fact to her mother. And her helplessness, she knows that she can't do anything. Her mother is on the verge of death, and the futility of the poets is anxiety. And this anxiety, this worry, it is futile. Nothing can be done. And therefore, she just wants to forget about it, because a person who is born is going to die. Her mother is on the verge of death, and she is going to lose her mother. What was her childhood fear? A childhood fear of loss of her mother. A childhood fear of separation from her mother. And she feels now that might happen. And that's why she wants to forget that. And using the poetic device here, she wants to emphasize that to the fact. All I did was smile and smile and smile. So the words smile, smile, smile are repeated. Now your imagery, the visual imagery, the pictures that are created in our minds. Doors, open mouth, a corpse. Now here, mother is dozing, she is sleeping, but how the corpse looks, how the dead body looks, the dead body, when you see that, mother looks like that of a dead body. She is dozing, her mouth is open, when you see a dead body, it appears like that. The phrase one about creates a picture of an old, decaying old woman. And this image is created in your mind. So visual image is created by the poet by comparing her mother's condition to that of her corpse. Young trees sprinting. Now here she is driving a car. She sees through the window outside, and when she sees that the trees are moving very fast. They are virtually sprinting. The merry children, the happy children, spilling out of their homes. They are moving out of their homes. And remember here, trees sprinting. Suddenly that image comes in your mind. And merry children spinning out. Happy children spinning out. Happy children moving out of their homes. So here, childhood is full of happiness. Youth is full of vigor, full of energy. So this phrase given above creates a picture of youthfulness and energy in our mind. So mental pictures are created through the imagery.
My mother at 66. We already seen some of the poetic devices used in this poem. The theme of this poem is aging and fear of loss and separation. Let us have a detailed study of this poem in order to recapitulate. My mother at 66. This poem is written by Kamala Das. In this poem, she has captured the complexities of human relationship. The poem My Mother at 66 is one of the finest examples of the human bonding, especially that of a mother and daughter. It describes the pain and fear of the poet of losing her mother due to harsh reality of life, which is death. Let us go to this poem and let us see in detail about this poem. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me. Now she was driving a car, was driving a car. The poetess was driving a car from her parents' home, from her ancestral home, and she was going towards Cochin. Why was she going to Cochin? She was going to Cochin because there was a airport and her mother wanted to go to airport and she was leaving her. She was going by air. I saw my mother beside me. I saw my mother by the side of me. Beside, alongside, by the side or next. She was sitting there in the car next to her. And how was her condition? Doors, open mouth, her face ashen like that of a corpse and realized with pain. Now, how was she? She was dozing. She was dozing means she was taking a nap. She was sleeping. Open mouth. Her mouth was open. Her face ashen like. Her face was looking like ash. Pale, grey, like ash. Now here the poet has used the poetic device simile. Her face ashen like that of a corpse. Her face is compared to that of a corpse, to dead body. What does corpse mean? Corpse means dead body. Now this is an example of simile. Her face ashen like that of a corpse and realized with pain. Now she realized with pain. Now here, what she has realized? She has realized that she was as old as she looked. She was looking quite old. She had grown old. And this thought probably made her to think about her death. She was on the verge of death. And a person, when he is an old man, is bound to die sooner. As she looked, but soon put that thought away. When that thought has come about her old age, about her separation, she wants to get rid of this thought. She wants to divert her mind. And in order to divert her mind, what does she do? And looked out at young trees sprinting. The merry children spilling. So she looked out of the window of the car and what does she see? She sees young trees sprinting. Now young trees sprinting. So trees are compared to the human action here and it is shown that it is sprinting. So it is an example of personification. The merry children. Now here merry children means happy children. They are running out of their homes. They are moving out of their homes. Merry children spilling out of their homes. So they are coming out of their homes. They are moving out very fast. So here on one hand it shows the childhood. On the other hand it shows youth. Youth which is full of vigor, youth wherein a person is full of activity, and childhood when a child is full of happiness, there is innocence, at the same time there is a happiness. And later after the airport security check, now she comes along with her mother at the airport. She reaches the airport and there at the airport security check, she is standing a few yards, and when she is standing a few yards, she looks at her mother. I looked again at her, wan, pale as a late winter's moon. She looks at her mother again, and how does she find? She finds her wan. She finds that her face has turned pale. She has become very weak. She has become very dull. Now, pale means colorless, dull, wan. So she is now comparing with late winter's moon. Now, late winter's moon, it doesn't have a shine. The moon in winter's, particularly late winter, it is not shiny. And here, mother's face had lost her youth. It has lost her shine. So youthly vigor is missing there. And she felt that old familiar ache. So that pain, probably the fear, my childhood's fear. Now what is that fear? That fear of separation. That fear of loss of a mother. That she is going to lose her. That she is going to die. So this fear, probably when she was a child, that probably I am going to lose my mother, that thought comes back to her. And this thought is a very sad to her. And she is not able to bear that pain of separation from her mother. And that's why that familiar ache, probably that pain, probably when she was a child, she was feeling about that childhood fear. When it comes to her, she wants to forget about her. She wants to get rid of that. And therefore what she does, but all I said was, see you soon, Amma. She knows that a person who is born, a person who is quite old, is bound to die. And she feels that her mother is about to die. And that's why she wants to forget about her. And probably she feels that this is the last time she's seeing her mother. She wants to hide that fear. And when she wants to hide that fear, she keeps on smiling. She keeps on smiling. And when she keeps on smiling, and she just wants to forget about all that, and that's why she just says, see you, Amma. Because she feels that she is not going to see her again. And to get rid of this thought, she just says, see you soon. And she bears the smile. She keeps on smiling because she wants to just forget about all that. She is trying to hide her fear and facing her mother. She doesn't want her to become aware of all that. And you can see here, there's a repetition. Smile and smile and smile. All I did was smile and smile and smile. So in order to emphasize, there's a poet has used that. Repetition use of smile is here. So here, the literary device which is used here is repetition. And remember, here, this poem is written, you can see that this poem is written in free verse. So here, right from the beginning till the end, you'll find that the poem is written in one sentence. So you can see there's a full stop at the end only. So it begins with driving from, and when it ends there, we can say that this poem is written in free verse. Thank you.